so excited to welcome in this 44th President of the United States. And saying here, it's not a day for politics, it is a day for patriots. And that's the feeling you get here on the Mall.
Megan, I stand by, because I want to get back to you. We're just continuing to look at this picture that you're seeing there on the right-hand side of the screen. That is President Obama. It's going to take some getting used to call him President Obama, not President-elect. He's in the president's room just off the Senate, and he is signing a bunch of papers. These are, we're told, housekeeping measures. For instance, when he nominated somebody to be Secretary of State, it didn't matter as president-elect. He's got to do it formally as president, so he's signing a number of those measures. Let's listen in and see if he's saying anything. Let's go to Carl Cameron. Excuse me just for a second, Fred. Carl Cameron is in the rotunda, and President Obama is going to be walking through there in a moment, heading over to Statuary Hall in the lunch. Carl, set the scene.
Well, Chris, we've seen quite a bit of activity in the last couple of minutes, and as we wait for the president to now leave the president's office on the Senate side of the Capitol, I want to show you the opposite door of the rotunda. We see before us John McCain, as well as in the aqua blue jacket, Cindy McCain. And just a short moment ago, we had the image of Secretary of State-designate Hillary Clinton, the senator from New York, talking with John Cornyn, the senator from Texas. Significant in that Senator Cornyn has prevented Mrs. Clinton's nomination to Secretary of State to go forward without a roll call vote. In fact, her back is now turned to us. You can see her in the purple jacket. That conversation with Mr. Cornyn went on for several minutes. It looked cordial. There were occasional smiles. But it was Mr. Cornyn who made it impossible for Senator Clinton's confirmation as Secretary of State to take place.
That bonded all of his films was the incredible virtuoso that he was with craft.
He was always on the cutting edge technically, and 2001's probably the best demonstration of his cutting edge knowledge.
It's become clear that this is one of the seminal American movies. It was a battle cry for a generation.
Everybody that I know now that has gone on to get awards and accolades were at that time just kids just starting out. And 2001 was the picture that just ignited the spark.
To see somebody actually do it, to make a visual film, was hugely inspirational to me. If he did it, I can do it. When 2001 first came out, I was in film school, which obviously it had a huge impact on me.
Anytime a Stanley Kubrick film came out, me and most of my friends were always the first in line to go see it.
You know, I remember very clearly the first day I saw 2001. It was opening day. The theater was really cold. And so when we were in space in the whole second half of the movie, I felt like I was on board the spaceship.
I had no idea about the kind of trip I was going to go on. And I went on one of the greatest trips of my life.
Shivers went up and down my spine. I mean, now that is the kind
as I'm concerned, predicted the future, not simply of space travel, but of the nature of the human soul.
It's puzzling. I don't think I've ever seen anything quite like this before.
Mr. Clinton, former President Bill Clinton, now getting prepared to join them for the luncheon. And dignitaries have been trickling in from various different sides of the rotunda. Now that the Bushes have departed, we're going to swing the camera back here to our left, Greg, so we can get prepared.
Can I ask you a question?
Yes, Greg.
Any idea why Senator Cornyn decided to put a hold?
President Obama's gone. Bush is gone. Look at them. They've been like this all afternoon. The enthusiasm is palpable. There's really no stopping the freight train that are Obama supporters here today. And I have to tell you, Chris, all week long, my morning co-host Bill Hemmer and I have been having an argument. Would you come out to the mall just to observe the events if you couldn't have a first-hand view of the actual swearing-in? I said, no way. Who wants to deal with the crowds, the cold? He said, oh, you guys do it just for the experience. I said he was wrong. I am willing to admit on national television today, he was right. I was wrong. To be in the midst of those millions with all the American flags waving, with a smooth and peaceful transition of power, it was something I will never forget. And I don't think these people here will either, Chris.
Megan, was there any particular line in President Obama's speech that seemed to strike a particular chord with the crowd around where you were?
The references, the...